In today's fast-paced, busy lives, making meals at home is a big challenge, especially when you are super busy and tired. When hunger strikes, we often find ourselves ordering food from outside, as it is convenient and fast as compared to the effort and time-taking activity of cooking at home. But this habit is extremely harmful for both our health and bank balance in long term. So today I have 5 Indian meal ideas for you for entire week that are quick, easy, tasty, wholesome, and require minimal ingredients. So let's get into the video. On Monday, I made vegetable khichdi. For this, take 1 cup or a bowl and add half of it with basmati rice or any kind of rice that you have, and the other half with split green lentils. Usually the rice content is little bit higher than half in khichdi, but I kept it equal to lentils because I wanted the goodness and protein content of the moong dal. In a pressure cooker on medium heat, heat up a little bit of oil, then add cumin seeds, black pepper, cloves, bay leaf, and whole green chili. Now I'm adding here this mix of frozen vegetables, but you can also add fresh vegetables if you have enough time to cut them up. I've added here some cauliflower, peas, carrots, green beans, and I see a little bit of Brussels sprouts as well. Now add the washed rice and lentils, 3 cups of water. Basically, it is 3 times the amount of rice and lentils that we used, along with some salt, turmeric powder, red chili powder, and garam masala. All boys, come on, make some noise and say, Om Shanti Mix it up and close the lid of the pressure cooker. Let it cook on medium heat for 10 minutes or until 2 whistles. Then let it rest for another 15 to 20 minutes and then open the lid. Now mix and mash up the khichdi a little bit. I like my khichdi a little bit on the thicker side, but if you prefer the thinner kind, you can add a little bit of more water and adjust the consistency according to your preference. Khichdi is generally made in India when we crave something light yet wholesome. It is a complete meal in itself, with the rice and lentils together forming a complete protein and lots of vegetables. Now serve the khichdi hot. Add a little bit of ghee on the top, which will enhance the taste of the khichdi 100 times. Garnish the khichdi with some coriander leaves and enjoy with a side of yogurt. I was so hungry when I made this and it was so yummy, it took me 5 minutes to finish this all. On Tuesday, I made sprouts chila and aloo shimla sabzi. For sprouts chila, we'll start with the sprouts. Here I had whole black lentils, or also called as urad dal, and I sprouted them at home, and that is what I am using here. You can use any kind of lentils or dal that you have at your home. We will add them to a blender along with 1 clove of garlic, little bit of salt, some black pepper, and blend it until it looks something like this. I've blended them coarsely, but if you want, you can even make more smoother paste out of it. Now we add here some kind of flour to give it more binding. I'm using here ragi flour, or also known as finger millet flour. You can use any kind of flour that you have at home. Also, we'll cut up the vegetables for the sabzi. So here I'm cutting 1 potato in thin slices, and also cutting some capsicum or green bell peppers. Now starting with the sprouts chila. This is my easier alternative for a roti or a naan, because that takes a little bit of more effort to cook, and sometimes when I want to eat Indian food, I don't want to spend so much time and effort. So this is like a very quick alternative and it is filled with protein and is so delicious. So we will spread it in the pan in circular motions as thin as possible, just like a pancake. Let it cook from one side and once the color changes to something like this, then you can turn it around and let it cook from the other side too before you remove it from the pan. Now in the same pan, we will start with making the sabzi. So we'll heat up a little bit of oil and then we'll start by adding our aromatics, which is cumin seeds and little bit of asafoetida or hing. If you don't have these items at home, don't worry about them. They're just there to add more flavor, but you can also skip them. Then we'll add our potatoes and capsicum and let them saute in the pan for about 2 to 3 minutes before adding the spices. Salt, turmeric powder, red chili powder, and coriander powder. Coriander powder tastes very good in all the potato curries. I love the taste. If you don't have it at home, then you can skip it also, but it is highly recommended. So once it is sauteed in the pan for like 2 minutes, add some water and cover up the pan until it cooks. For me, it took about 7 to 8 minutes. Then you can remove the lid and check if the sabzi is done by softly pressing the potatoes, and if they are soft enough, then your curry is done. Now we will serve with our sprouts chila or roti alternative, the sabzi, some ginger julienne, some coriander leaves, and a little bit of lemon juice. You can also serve some yogurt on the side before eating. This dish was so filling and tasty, and it took me only 10 minutes to make it. So whenever you're craving Indian food and don't want to put a lot of effort, then this is a very good option. On Wednesday, it rained here a bit, so I was feeling chilly and was craving for soup. So I made ragi rabri with vegetables. Ragi flour, also known as finger millet flour, is extremely healthy and nutritious and looks something like this. We will take 2 spoons of the flour in a bowl and add 1 spoon of yogurt. To help mix the batter, we will add a little bit of water into it. I'm planning to add black chickpeas in the soup going forward, so I'm using the water that I boiled the black chickpeas in, and hence you see this little black chickpea sneak in into the batter right now. We will mix it thoroughly until it becomes homogeneous and looks something like this. We will heat up a pan, add the batter along with 2 more cups of water. Mix it all until it is combined thoroughly. And then we will add our black chickpeas or protein for the meal, and for vegetables I'm adding here some carrots and spinach. You can go for any kinds of lentils and beans for the protein and any vegetables that you have lying around in the fridge. After 10 minutes it will start simmering and thicken up a little bit, at which point we will add our salt and black pepper and mix and cook it for 5 more minutes. Once the desired consistency is reached, we will transfer the rabri into a soup. Rabri is a traditional Rajasthani dish. It is made with yogurt as we saw here, and that gives it a little bit of sour taste. In winters, it is consumed hot like we are having it today, and in summers, it is consumed the next day cold with a lot of buttermilk. Generally, the vegetables and the lentils or beans are not added in here, but I have added them because I wanted to make it a wholesome meal. I also decorated it here with some pomegranate seeds that I had in my fridge, but it is completely optional. It turned out even better than I imagined, and I think the main key ingredient here is the black chickpeas. They gave it a really nice depth of flavor and it was so yummy. On Thursday, I made rajma pulao. It is spicy and garlicky and everything Indian. So heat up a little bit of mustard oil in a pressure cooker on medium heat and add one bay leaf, very little small piece of cinnamon stick, some black pepper, cloves, cumin seeds, and hing again. You can also skip all of these things if you don't have them in your pantry. Then we will add some grated ginger and garlic and some chopped onions. Toss them around for 1 minute before adding some potatoes. And we will add a little splash of water to help it cook and not stick to the bottom. We will also add one whole green chili and some salt to help the cooking be a little bit faster. Then we will add our rajma or black beans, half cup of soaked and washed rice, and a lot of rajma masala. Rajma masala you can find in your nearby Indian grocery stores, but if you don't have access to it, you can also add curry spice mix or any kind of Indian spice mix that you have in your pantry. If you don't have anything, then you can go ahead with salt, turmeric powder, red chili powder, and some garam masala. Once we mix all of it, we will go ahead and add the water, which is 1.5 times the amount of rice that we added. Then add a little bit of more salt and give it a quick mix, then close the lid and let it cook again for 10 minutes on medium heat and rest for 15 minutes without the heat. And it is done. It was so easy and the outcome is amazing. It is one of my favorite go-to meals and I like to enhance the flavors by adding some chopped coriander leaves and squeezing some lemon juice. Lemon juice has a lot of vitamin C, which helps the absorption of iron present in the beans or lentils. So don't forget adding them into your meals. I love rajma chawal, but it takes just so much effort to cook them separately. So the times when I crave rajma chawal and don't want to put in so much of effort, I go ahead with this one pot rajma pulao meal, which satisfies all my cravings. And you can enjoy it with a side of yogurt. On Friday, I made vegetable uttapam with lots of fresh vegetables and black chickpeas for protein. So for this, we'll start by taking a bowl and add semolina into it, and to this we will add yogurt. For 1 cup of semolina, we add half cup of yogurts and little bit of water to help it mix. We will mix it together in a homogeneous paste and leave it to rest for 10 to 15 minutes. This way the semolina will soak up the moisture. Then we'll go ahead and add all the fresh vegetables that we want. Here I'm adding some tomatoes, onions, coriander leaves, green chilies, some spinach leaves, and a lot of black chickpea. Then we'll also add some salt, black pepper, red chili powder, and give it all a good mix. Usually the lentils or beans are not added to uttapam, but I add them to anything that I think will benefit from a little bit of protein. And the batter is ready. Now we'll heat up a pan and a little bit of oil, and then we'll add some mustard seeds, cumin seeds, curry leaves, and hing. Spread it across the pan evenly and start making little pancakes out of the batter. You can even make a bigger uttapam, but since I added so many vegetables and chickpeas, it will be a little bit difficult to handle a bigger uttapam. So I've added 3 very small portions, just like small pancakes. And once it is cooked from one side, I will turn them and let them cook from the other side as well. It will take about 10 minutes on medium heat, and once cooked from both the sides, we will remove it from the pan into the plate. And they are ready to eat. You can have them with sriracha, normal tomato ketchup, some yogurt, or even some coconut chutney. I am having them as they are right now because I was extremely hungry and they were hot and delicious and did not require anything in my opinion. So those were all the meal ideas. I make them quite often and they are all super quick and healthy, and I think you must give them a try. Let me know in the comments below which of the meals you like the most. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.